Welcome to this video. Using self-hypnosis to manage pain. Living in pain on a daily basis should not be the way one should live their life. For the most part, pain management includes the use of painkillers. These painkillers not only dull the pain but also makes a person sleepy to the point they miss out on so much in life. Painkillers also destroy the liver and kidneys, causes the person even more pain. This seems to be a vicious cycle that really is unnecessary. Self-hypnosis has been used by many to alleviate chronic pain. You can learn how to use self-hypnosis to manage your pain and thus avoid the health risks associated with painkillers. Self-hypnosis for pain management can give you back your life. If you are new to self-hypnosis, then start by reading up on what you can about self-hypnosis. Learn how to do an induction and how to deepen the trance of a hypnosis session. Once you have the basics of hypnosis down, then you can move on to how to use hypnosis to manage your pain. When you are ready to learn how to use self-hypnosis to manage your pain, there are books out there that will teach you all that you need to know. These great authors have put together books that will walk you through it and have you out of pain. Dr. Bruce Eimer has written a book called Hypnotize Yourself Out of Pain Now. In his book, he will explain what self-hypnosis is and help you to find the right imagery that will work for you. Rising Above Pain by Susie Rotch is another great book to help you learn how to use self-hypnosis to manage chronic pain. Both of the above books are great for even beginners who are looking to alleviate pain from their lives. But sometimes you may need more than just a book to read to help you use self-hypnosis to manage your pain. When you need more than a book, there is a great audio tape available that will guide you through the self-hypnosis session. The use of this audio tape during self-hypnosis is the subliminal messages that the tape send to your subconscious mind during a hypnosis session. This allows for the mind to redirect signals so that the body is not feeling the pain. Jeff Gaisley has put together a great audio tape called Pain Reduction that can be used during a self-hypnosis session. Jeff Gaisley is a certified hypnotherapist who has over 33 years of clinical experience. With the use of the books and the audio tape, you will be able to advance through self-hypnosis and have your pain under control, thus cutting back on the amount of painkillers that you need to use. Once you have your pain under control and your painkillers to a minimum, you can finally get back to living your life. No longer must you sit on the sidelines while everyone else lives their lives to the fullest. Self-hypnosis for sports coaches. Sports coaches are always looking for ways to enhance their team's performance. One way that a sports coach can help his, her players be better is to use self-hypnosis sessions in a group with the team. Self-hypnosis can keep the team focused and motivated, it can help build confidence in each member of the team, and overall performance of the team will improve. As the coach, you need to learn what you can about self-hypnosis techniques and inductions. Then teach this with your team members. This will allow for all of you to be together and benefit from self-hypnosis. You will not be hypnotizing your team, but they will be hypnotizing themselves for a shared hypnosis session. So it is important that you make sure that all team members know how to do an induction into hypnosis. The next thing is to have the positive messages that will be used ready. Have all team members read and memorize the positive messages that will be used during the self-hypnosis session. This way, all team members will know what messages to say and use during the session. Avoid using any negative words during the session. The mind will grasp onto the negative words and miss all the positive words. So keep all words positive so that the subconscious mind will grasp only onto the positive, and this will be what follows over into the conscious mind. Positive phrases can be along the lines of, I am a great athlete, I am proficient in my abilities as an athlete, I can win the game, I am a strong athlete. As you can see, all the words in these phrases were positive words. You can use any combination of positive words and phrases that will fit your team. Now that you have your knowledge of self-hypnosis and have taught this to your team, you can start using self-hypnosis sessions with your team to build your team members up. Find an area where as a team you can be uninterrupted and everyone can sit comfortably. Then as the couch, start the session and have everyone begin their induction. Once everyone has reached a deep level of hypnosis, begin using the positive messages. After the hypnosis session, watch and see what progress mentally and physically you are seeing in your team members. Sometimes positive messages have to be done to fit the individual. So if what you are using is not working, then try using different positive messages with the next hypnosis session and see if those fit to enhance your athletes. If you need help, there are audio tapes available for sports self-hypnosis that can be used during self-hypnosis sessions. These audio tapes may give you the edge you are needing. Also, confidence boosting audio tapes may work to build up the confidence of your team. Just experiment with what works for your team and don't be afraid to try new things. Self-hypnosis is safe and you cannot cause any harm to your team members. Research on self-hypnosis to stop smoking. For some time, self-hypnosis was viewed as radical. A lot of people did not believe that self-hypnosis worked. As time went on, more and more people started looking into self-hypnosis and seeing the benefits of using self-hypnosis to change things about themselves that they did not like. Smoking is one bad habit that people have used hypnosis for. I logged into several chat rooms to poll the chatters and get their insight into how they view the effects of self-hypnosis on smoking. What I found was shocking, considering all the positive news on the use of hypnosis to stop smoking. When I polled the people, I was able to discover was that women seemed to be more accepting than men on different approaches to stop a bad habit. While the majority of the women I polled leaned toward believing that hypnosis could help one to stop smoking, the women did not believe that self-hypnosis would work. The majority of the women said that hypnosis would only, in their opinion, work if the person used a trained hypnotist. Men, on the other hand, did not believe that hypnosis would work whether a hypnotist was used or not. Thus showing that men seemed to lean more toward traditional methods more so than women. Most hypnotists that work with people who want to stop smoking boast a high success rate. This high success rate generates them more and more clients all the time that are seeking to stop smoking. So why then are these hypnotists able to flourish with such lack of doubt in their methods within the majority of the public's mind? I polled more people to get a better understanding from the viewpoint of people as to why, with so much skeptics surrounding hypnosis and even self-hypnosis, are hypnotists still able to receive a large number of new and repeat clients. Men and women both seemed to view this from the same standing. What I learned was that in the minds of people, this business is flourishing because, despite skeptics, people are willing to try anything to get what they want. As for repeat clients, I learned that people view this happening because people, for the most part, believe that the more you do something, eventually the result will differ. As for self-hypnosis, the people that I polled believed that these people are desperate for results but don't want to spend the money to achieve the results that they want. This desperation to stop smoking has them latching on to the notion that self-hypnosis will help them to stop smoking. So the end results of my research shows that women are more likely to believe that hypnosis works to stop smoking if the hypnosis is done with a hypnotist. While women are skeptic about self-hypnosis working. Men, on the other hand, are skeptic about either form of hypnosis working. The last results I gathered shows why hypnosis and self-hypnosis is flourishing in society despite skeptics. In a nutshell, is because as humans we will try anything that is offered to gain the results we are so desperately seeking. How self-hypnosis can help a housewife. As a housewife, you are probably feeling pretty run down and underappreciated. This can all change by changing how you see yourself. Your self-view can change how you respond to everyday hassles associated with being a housewife. Self-hypnosis can help you to reprogram how your brain responds to everyday hassles. Self-hypnosis can face almost anything that is standing in your way. You just need to take the time to evaluate your life and see what is standing in your way. Then find the self-hypnosis technique that will confront that roadblock. Realizing you have a low self-esteem can be devastating. But with self-hypnosis there to help you build your self-esteem, you can look at the knowledge that you have a low self-esteem as something you can fix easily. Just use the self-hypnosis techniques that are designed to build your self-esteem up and you will see a more self-confident you in no time. Know that you have a weight problem after becoming a housewife can be frustrating. More than likely you have tried many dieting programs that have failed you in the past. This leaves most housewives feeling run down and undesirable. Self-hypnosis can change your weight by reprogramming your subconscious. Most the time our weight problems is not in the fact that we don't try to take care of ourselves, but in the fact of how our subconscious mind sends messages to our bodies. This reprogramming will allow you to lose the weight. Once the weight is gone, you will see a more sexier housewife, and so will your husband. Sometimes as housewives we need to be more assertive, but we lack the ability to be assertive in our own homes. This is another area where self-hypnosis can help. Self-hypnosis can reprogram the way that our mind reacts to situations. As it stands now, our minds react to situations in a way that makes us back down and not take a stand. It holds us back by making us fear a confrontation. With self-hypnosis, we can program our minds to make us not fear this confrontation and allow us to be assertive. As you can see, there are many situations in which a housewife may face that self-hypnosis can help with. Being new to self-hypnosis, you will want to read as much as you can on self-hypnosis. This will allow you to see the facts about hypnosis, the myths that surround hypnosis, and learn some great techniques that you can use. Self-hypnosis takes time, so read as much as you can and you will find what methods works best for you. When you are ready to begin using self-hypnosis, you may be interested in using something during the session to help you along. Audio tapes that have been designed for use during self-hypnosis can help to make the session go easier for you. Just make sure to use a tape that is designed for the type of self-hypnosis session you will be doing. Thank you for watching this video. Hopefully you found it useful and worthwhile. Please remember to subscribe if you have not already done so. There will be new information for you published regularly. Also, check out the other links. Click for more information in the description below.